Hi, my name is Ye. I'm a PhD student at CMU. I will talk about our work SimPoE, Simulated Character Control for 3D Human Pose Estimation. Currently, all state-of-the-art 3D human pose estimation methods are kinematics-based, which means they do not model the physical forces underlying the human motion. As a result, the motion they produce can be accurate but physically implausible, with physical artifacts such as foot sliding, jitter, and ground penetration. To address this, prior work has used physics-based trajectory optimization for human pose estimation. However, there are several limitations with this method. First, they require batch optimization at test time, which can be slow and have high latency. Second, they require additional contact estimation modules, which can be error-prone. And the optimization is also not compatible with advanced physics simulator. Finally, there is no learning process in the physics reasoning part to ensure that the final output is close to the ground truth. To tackle these issues, we propose SimPoE, a method that integrates both kinematics and dynamics modeling to achieve accurate and also physically plausible human pose estimation. At a high level, SimPoE uses a recurrent unit called Kinematics plus Dynamics module to map a sequence of video frames into human poses. So from a temporal modeling perspective, we are essentially replacing recurrent units such as LSTM with our more structured Kinematics plus Dynamics module. The module includes a physics simulator, which is like a non-differentiable gating function. Therefore, supervised learning cannot be applied here. Instead, we use reinforcement learning-based character control to learn this module. Inside the module, we use a kinematic pose estimator such as Wipe to get initial kinematic pose from the image. And we also use a keypoint detector to get 2D keypoints and their confidence. We then use a kinematics-aware policy that takes as input the kinematic pose, the keypoints, and also the current character pose and velocity to produce an action. And the action is converted by PD controllers to join torques and input into the physics simulator to produce the next pose of the character. This whole process can be looked at in the context of reinforcement learning, where we use the kinematics-aware policy to control the character agent inside physics simulation and assigns a reward to the agent based on how the generated motion aligns with the ground truth. Inside the kinematics-aware policy, we perform kinematics reasoning with a kinematic refinement unit that iteratively refines the pose estimates based on the key points. The refined pose is then used by a control generation unit to produce control action of the character agent. Our character agent is created from human mesh models such as SMPL. We use the skinning weight matrix to obtain the vertices belonging to each bone. And then we compute the 3D convex hull of the bone vertices to obtain each bone's geometry. We design different rewards to match policy-generated motion with the ground truth. Specifically, we use rewards that match joint rotation, joint velocity, 3D joint positions, and 2D key points. We combine the rewards using multiplication. Quantitative results show that, on both human 3.6 million and the in-house motion dataset, SimPoE beats prior kinematic and physics-based methods in both pose-based and physics-based metrics. In particular, SimPoE substantially outperforms prior physics-based approaches. Here we show qualitative results of SimPoE. We can see that SimPoE has little physical artifacts such as foot sliding, jitter, and ground penetration compared to kinematic-based methods. And SimPoE produces more natural and realistic human motions. Thank you for listening. More details can be found on the project webpage.